My name is Theo Bowie from Harvard Medical School, and today I'll be presenting on the approach to acute vision loss in the emergency department. In this video, we will discuss vital aspects of a history to obtain, various physical exam techniques that should be employed to narrow the differential diagnosis. We will demonstrate how to evaluate for an afferent pupillary defect and illustrate selected relevant fundoscopic findings. We will also emphasize key elements of the history and physical that will narrow the differential to a process in the media versus in the retina versus in the brain. Pathology that results in acute vision loss can be subcategorized into occurring in the media, the retina, or in the brain. Media processes typically cause more subacute vision loss, but some, such as vitreous hemorrhage or rapid onset endophthalmitis or uveitis, can lead to acute vision loss. Retinal processes include retinal detachments, acute macular processes, or retinal vascular issues. Acute onset neurologic processes that lead to acute vision loss include vascular occlusion, hemorrhagic strokes, trauma, structural compression, or optic nerve processes. We will discuss processes that fall into these categories in greater depth in subsequent videos. This video will cover how to use history and physical to narrow down the possible etiologies of a patient's acute vision loss. Many aspects of the history can help in the evaluation of acute vision loss. For one, timing. Was a vision loss truly acute? Was it over seconds, minutes, hours, or was it noticed first upon awakening? This is all key information to gather. Additionally, was it monocular or binocular? Associated with pain? There are a few true causes of acute vision loss that cause pain. Optic neuritis can have pain, but with movement, and some anterior chamber processes can be involved in acute, but more likely subacute processes that can cause vision loss. Is there any redness associated? Are there other associated symptoms, for instance, neurological deficits, nausea and vomiting, headache?
Was there a trauma? Trauma can cause hyphema, which is blood in the anterior chamber of the eye, vitreous hemorrhage, retinal commotio, which is a bruise of the retina, retinal detachment, or traumatic optic neuropathy. Trauma can also cause a globe rupture.
Past medical and ocular history can give important clues to the etiology of vision loss as well. Previous surgeries can predispose to endophthalmitis, uveitis, or retinal detachment. Certain medical diseases can give clues to suggest certain causes of acute vision loss. It is also important to ask about vascular disease. Patients who smoke or have history of diabetes mellitus, coronary artery disease, peripheral vascular disease, hypertension, or other vascular risk factors are at increased risk for retinal vascular occlusion, ischemic optic neuropathy, or visual pathway stroke. Patients with pre-existing diabetic retinopathy can experience a vitreous hemorrhage or a retinal detachment, which can also cause acute onset vision loss. The patient's age can also narrow the differential. Certain causes, such as giant cell arteritis, can be ruled out if the patient is a child, for example. It's also important to ask about medications. Both systemic and ocular medications can be associated with side effects. Most of these side effects would cause vision loss on a subacute scale. However, a good history would include these factors. Additional history factors that are important include refractive status and contact lens status. Very myopic eyes are predisposed to retinal detachments, and contact lens wearers are at an increased risk for severe anterior chamber or ocular surface infections. Physical exam should start with a general inspection. A thorough pupillary exam should be done with particular attention to the symmetry of the red reflexes. Next, a swinging flashlight test should then be performed to evaluate for an afferent pupillary defect. An afferent pupillary defect is demonstrated by shining a light alternately in one eye and then the other in a dark room, with a subject fixating on a distant target to prevent accommodative meiosis. If the direct response to light is sluggish in one eye, this is positive for an afferent pupillary defect in this eye. The video that will follow shows a normal subject without an afferent pupillary defect, and then a subject who does have an afferent pupillary defect. Other important parts of the physical exam include the intraocular pressure measurement and visual acuity testing, particularly with pinhole testing. Pinhole testing helps evaluate whether the pathology that's causing the acute visual loss is in the anterior chamber or on the ocular surface versus in the retina. Other important physical exam tests include evaluation of extraocular movements, visual field testing, fluorescein examination, slit lamp examination, and fundoscopic exam. Fundoscopic exam in particular can often clearly reveal pathology, which can explain acute onset vision loss. Some select fundoscopic images are shown here. In the top left, you can see an example of arteritic ischemic optic neuropathy. Top right, a regmatogenous retinal detachment. And on the bottom, you can see evidence of retinal commotio and vitreous hemorrhage. To summarize some key concepts, there are many etiologies of acute vision loss, and a useful schema to classify these are those that are occurring in the media, the retina, or the brain. A good history and physical exam are necessary to both narrow the differential diagnosis and uncover the acute process that is causing this vision loss.